We are in Puglia, and this episode we're visiting the whitewashed labyrinth of Ostuni. Andiamo! Ostuni is a town of 30,079 inhabitants, located in the province of Brindisi and the region of Puglia. Driving through the beautiful Valle d'Itria, you will see Ostuni long before you arrive. The vast white city rises high above the ocean of olive trees that sweep through this verdant area of Puglia. Ostuni, perched on three hills, is located inside the Itria Valley, 218 meters above sea level. It is about 42 kilometers northwest of Brindisi and only 8 kilometers from the Adriatic coast. You can get to the Centro Storico in Ostuni by trains from all major cities in Italy. The train station itself lies about 2 kilometers from the old town, but there is a public bus service that connects the train station to the Centro Storico. One of my favorite experiences of staying in Ostuni was to wake up and explore the center before the town itself had woken up. The mystique of the town is so alluring when you have it to yourself. And if you plan accordingly, you can also grab a cappuccino when the local bar opens as well. Piazza Beto Giovanni Paolo II, 18th century buildings you may notice are the Palazzo Vescovile and the old Seminario are elegantly connected by the fascinating Scopa Arch. Facing the cathedral, this passage, originally a wooden bridge that had to be replaced, is a marvel of well-proportioned Italian architecture and decorative art. Many find the arch comparable in nature to the Bridge of Sighs found in Venice. At the ground floor of Palazzo Episcopio, the Diocesan Museum holds and exhibits the extraordinary historic artistic heritage of the Ostuni Church, with internationally renowned masterpieces. This popular bar offers some delicious gelati and granite, so many beautiful flavors to choose from to help beat the summer sun. A splendid example of 15th century Romanesque and Gothic architecture and declared a national monument in 1902, the Cathedral of Ostuni, perched on the town's highest hilltop, is the town's beating heart. Restored in the late 1400s in the aftermath of a strong earthquake, the cathedral features a three-portal facade topped by three rose windows, of which the central one is divided into 24 segments by stone mullions and tracery with the figure of Christ in the middle, holding the earth in his hand as a sign of protection, surrounded by the apostles and seven heads of cherubs. Belonging to a holiday apartment let, this door, painted with different shades of blue, is an icon in Ostuni and one of the most photographed spots. Together, with the sea showing just over the surrounding white wall, forms a poetic layering of colors. It's in fact often used in commercials. One of the most beautiful towns of southern Italy, Ostuni, is also known as the Città Bianca, or the White City, thanks to its whitewashed painted houses. Considered as one of the most genuine and fascinating examples of Mediterranean architecture, Ostuni unveils an historic old town called by the locals La Terra, formed by a suggestive, charming, and poetic tangle of narrow roads, palazzi with their staircases, arches, churches, and marvelous views. Ostuni takes perfect advantage of its small streets and tiny alleys by creating imaginative restaurants and bars around every possible corner. La Terra is the old town of Ostuni, the historical part, protected by walls giving the impression of a cone sitting within the hills. It's the medieval part, the oldest, and most fascinating, formed by narrow streets, whitewashed houses, and palaces embellished with geraniums, suddenly opening onto enchanting glimpses of small artisan shops, ateliers, restaurants, cocktail bars, and gelaterie. Via Cattedrale is the main street of Ostuni, which climbs right up to the cathedral from Piazza Libertà. It curls and turns on a slight slope, busy with tourists and locals alike, visiting the numerous restaurants, shops, bars, and galleries. A great place to people watch and to feel the lively nature of the town. It's best to soak in the atmosphere, especially on a weekend, when the town truly comes to life. Walking around Ostuni Old Town is definitely the best way to make the most of your time here. However, another fun way to enjoy the city is by riding a legendary three-wheeler, Ape Calasino, one of Italy's most iconic vehicles alongside the Vespa, the vintage Fiat 500, and so many more. Now, do keep in mind that the Ape tours can be quite pricey, even when just being a drop-off to a different location in the town. If you're visiting in low season, just be sure to do so in the morning when the town comes alive before the afternoon pausa. If visiting during summer, adjust to the locals' eating times and head out in the balmy summer evenings after dark from about 8 o'clock or 9 p.m. to see a wonderful contrast as Italian families venture out to eat, drink, and have a chat. Did you know that I'm a travel advisor? Going to Italy or perhaps to another bucket list destination? I'd love to work with you, so feel free to contact me for more information. Dating back to the invasion of Angioni, the whitewashed walls of the White City were built to protect the old town from enemy threats. After the earthquake of 1456, the Aragonese wanted the walls restored and defensive perimeter was widened. The city would throw stones and boiling oil from the top of the walls onto any invaders below. The walls had four entrances, the Porta San Francesco, Porta del Ponte, the Porta Nova, and Porta San Demetrio, but only the latter two have survived. Saunter along the walls to enjoy peaceful views of the Adriatic Sea and the checkerboard of olive groves surrounding the old city. Walking alongside the walls was an incredibly magical experience to me. Having stayed in the town for a couple of weeks, I would bring a novel and sit alongside the white wall, with the passerbys on my left and the olive groves and the sea in the distance on my right. It's a feeling and memory I won't ever forget. Beneath Piazza Libertà, the space has a concentration of restaurants and bars that in the evening comes alive with bustling activity. Piazza della Libertà is Ostuni's largest square and the one that gives the town its true Italian feel. Buzzing with life all day long, the square is Ostuni's major social hub and home to a couple of magnificent landmarks as well. The most striking is Palazzo San Francesco, a former convent that now houses Ostuni's town hall, alongside the adjoining church of San Francesco d'Assisi. On the other end, you can actually admire the 20 meters high obelisk of sant'Oronzo, saint patron of the town. The column, almost 21 meters high, also known as the spire, stands in Piazza della Libertà and was built in 1771 by Giuseppe Greco. The statue depicts sant'Oronzo in the act of blessing people. In fact, it's said that the saint saved the city of Ostuni from the plague. The first part of the column was buried due to road leveling works in the first half of the 19th century, but in 1997, a restoration was carried out which today gives the monument an excellent state of conservation. A lovely local dish to try, bombette, or fresh pork meat rolls, stuffed and grilled, usually include a filling based with cheese and spices. With many varied toppings, the bruschettone is a perfect starter or main dish. The one I ordered here has some regional capocollo from Martina Franca and burrata di Puglia. The Church of Santo Spirito was built in 1637 at the command of Bishop Melingi, and initially, the priests of the College of San Carlo officiated there. On an architectural level, the building has a single nave with a stone vault and arch. The characteristic city wall of Ostuni that we see today is the result of all the interventions over the centuries, but above all, of the 1995 intervention which allowed the walls to be refreshed for all visitors who wanted to see it in all its white splendor. Ostuni Old Town is an acropolis surrounded by strong defensive walls. The walls of the city now offer the opportunity for one of the most enchanting strolls, especially during sunset. It is only then that Ostuni's blinding white gives way to the sweetest hue of gold. The fortified Porta Nova offers access to the Centro Storico, whereas once you pass through the doorway, you are transported to an ancient, forgotten world. One of my absolute favorite things to do while in Italy is to go to a local bar and order a crema di caffè. It's smooth, creamy, and a coffee lover's dream. While the pasticciotto is a typical dessert made of shortcrust pastry filled with custard and occasionally cherry. The real magic of Ostuni is the maze of alleyways, staircases, and arches of houses built upon houses. Many unexpected dead ends and pretty little gardens with glimpses of the Adriatic Sea, olive trees with green doors and bright blue skies. What comes around the next corner is anyone's guess, but it's always some sort of beautiful surprise. The old white houses are built one next to the other, creating the illusion that the entire town is just one single building. The countless arches that connect the buildings are yet another unique characteristic of the town. The white color has been used here since the Middle Ages, or even earlier, and has several practical preferences. First, it helps to keep the premises in the buildings cool. White color is refracting most of the warmth. Second, the lime has been an effective disinfectant in the times of epidemics. And third, and perhaps the most popular, limestone is readily available in the surroundings of the city. Ostuni's countryside is dotted with masserie, farmsteads, mostly turned into holiday farmhouses called agriturismo and luxury resorts. The first examples of a masseria date back to the time of Greek colonization between the 8th and 6th century BC. The territory of Ostuni preserves still more than 200 farms, some of which, very old of private property, can be visited with the permission of the owners. You will actually see a masseria experience in Ostuni in an upcoming episode of mine called Postcard from Puglia. Decoration of the facade in the church is very sober, with 19th century lines that define the upper triangle, the lunetted portal, and the rounded window. The church was built in 1870 at the expense of the Aroldi family, not far from Piazza Libertà. The sanctuary of Madonna della Grotta is a small church that stands in a prominent position outside the historical center, surrounded by gardens in a rural area known as Contrada Rosara. I hope you all enjoyed this overview of the beautiful Città Bianca, Ostuni. Until next time, alla prossima! Did you enjoy this episode? Please hit the like button and subscribe to be in the know for future episodes.